Big Shanks pretty proud of his ring wear. Having fun with his shoes and his opponent's shoes now. Well, there's the golden boy showing off his gold. I don't really know what to make of any of this. Size advantage going to Spencer Wallace, who is choosing to duck into the ropes to begin the match.
Not really sure what's going on here. He seemed pretty eager to engage earlier.
I think we're in for a pretty rough contest here. I don't think we're going to see anything too pretty out of either of these guys. This will be a battle for dominance between them, I think.
Golden Boy grabbing the hair.
I think Shank is angry enough without insulting him or slapping his chest. And I think Spencer might agree with me now that he's down on the mat with his head being wrenched around.
Putting a stop to that push-off, holding on to that headlock.
He's putting so much into such a simple move.
There's Spencer going to the hair again. Not this time. Shank wrenches that headlock.
Shank might have the best-looking headlock I've ever seen. I can't believe I'm saying that, but he might have the best headlock I have ever seen.
He's not finding a way out of that headlock. That thing is locked in there. Going to the hair again. Ooh!
If you...
Eventually you get sick of somebody pulling your hair and you pull back. Spence can't even get him off the ground. Oh! And there's a drag and he's still stuck in that headlock.
He still has the headlock. I love this so much. This is as basic as it gets, ladies and gentlemen, but it is so effective.
Rolls him over for a pin. Not gonna happen. Back in the headlock.
Forget the pace of the match being dictated. The pace of the blood to Spencer Wallace's brain is being dictated by Shank right now.
And now Shank going to the arm. Wrenching it. Throwing him to the corner. Golden Boy with the counter.
Oh.
Shank goes up, over, spins around. Two count. Golden Boy missing. Schoolboy. Two count. Shank shoulder blocking Wonder or Golden Boy to the ground. And Golden Boy retreating to the outside.
Shank Barzini looks to be a master of the basics, the fundamentals of professional wrestling. We just saw him take the fight to a man who looked almost twice his size. And he did it with just a headlock. Just a headlock.
Now he's got the Golden Boy running around. I think Spencer Wallace is trying to get blood back to his head before he gets in, but Shank's all over him. He's not letting him in the ring. Ref getting in between them.
I think that this is the only way that Spencer can really keep any control in the match is if he just doesn't get in the ring with Shank. It looks like if Shank gets his hands on you, he has the say in how things are going to go. And I don't think Spencer wants Shank to get his hands on him again. I wouldn't either.
Spence rolling in and he's right back out.
One! Two!
I don't know. Maybe getting counted out is a better option than oh.
And Shank to the outside and Spence back in.
But now Spencer Wallace has the high ground, and you know what that means.
Two!
Shank in, and Golden Boy right back out.
No, I thought the power advantage went to Spencer Wallace, but from what we've seen from Shank, I'm really not sure at this point.
Shank out of the ring, and Spence right back in. This can't go on forever.
They're doing a pretty good job so far.
Shank pointing to his hand. Looks like he's got an idea. Faking into the ring. Wonderboy thinks he's out. He thinks he's outsmarted something. Heavy right hand. He's finally got his hands on Wonderboy again.
It was so basic, but it was so effective.
That pretty much sounds like Shank's whole strategy. Oh, no! Good God, he misses the chop and hits the pillar of the Opera House. That had to hurt. Using that barricade. Oh, right back to the arm.
I don't think Spencer's going to be doing any right-handed strikes after this. Not if he knows what's good for him.
Going right back to the barricade. Letting the crowd get involved a little bit. Shank is having the time of his life down here. Oh, Golden Boy with his first offensive move of the match. Kicking the ropes as Shank comes in.
But it got the job done.
Yeah, that'll take the wind out of anyone's sails. Shakes Shank off the ropes. There's a tongue twister. Drops a forearm right to the midsection.
You've got to hand it to Spencer. That one move really turned things around for him. It may have been a little unethical in this contest. But you
Shank
can't.
Trying to fight back, not working well.
The composure of this entire match has been drastically changed from one kick to the ropes. And it's gonna take a little while for Shank to get his composure after this.
Maybe not. Spencer with the strike and Shank with the strike back, and Spencer right to the eyes.
You'll notice that Spencer was, oh.
Snapmare, Shank on the ground. Oh, Spencer dropping a knee right to the spine.
We definitely have a strike-heavy game at this point. Spencer's looking at that hand that he beat up earlier.
Yeah, that thing has to be useless. Shank with the shoulder block right to his stomach.
He's still trying to use the hand. I don't know how effective it is.
Oh.
You can see most of his strikes aren't with the hand now. They're the elbow or the forearm instead.
Yeah, that was a big forearm right to his back. Spencer's a heavy, heavy boy. He drops that weight on that forearm. Whoa. That right hand had no effect. Headbutt. Shank repeated headbutts. That might not be where you want to strike on him.
I said this match probably wouldn't be pretty, and we're seeing that now.
Schoolboy roll up by Wonder 2.
Oh. That was a mean forearm shot. Shank just hasn't been the same since he took that indirect low blow from the middle rope when he was getting in the ring earlier.
Hasn't been the same, but hasn't taken all the wind out of sails. He's had some offense, looks like he's getting back up, and if Spencer Wallace keeps affording him the time to get up and throw some strikes. He might be back in it before you know it. Oh, right back to the eyes.
Neither of these men are too concerned about the well-being of each other. This is not a gentleman's contest we're seeing here. This is just an ugly fight. A fight that I honestly thought that... Oh, and here he comes. Shank, definitely with the speed and agility advantage, he's using it now.
Rolls into the ring, trying to take Golden Boy down, hits him once, hits him twice.
Can you see the look on his face after that first hit? He's dazed.
Counters the arm drags him in. Boom, kick right to the face. That was not the move for Shank. And that wasn't the move for Golden Boy. He spins around, misses the hit. Shank with the kick to the stomach. Looks like he's going for the shoulder block. And he goes right to the ground. I don't know which one is harder on this guy, honestly.
He might have headbutted him with that. Either way, it was pretty ugly.
Yeah, Shank going to the top rope. It's gonna be something head related. You can use that hard head, right?
The straps are coming down. This does not look good for Spencer Wallace.
Oh, diving headbutt.
Right to the chest.
He doesn't even seem affected by it. Two. There it is.
Oh, Shank did so much damage to Spencer Wallace, to a much larger opponent, for the duration of that match. Spencer tried and tried to get ahead with some dirty tactics. It worked for a little while, but Shank just kept coming back. You can see just from the basics, just from even a headlock at the beginning to headbutts. He didn't need to do anything fancy, anything elaborate. He stuck to the basics and he won with it.